A very good morning, Zimbabwe. It's your girl, Dr. Mai. Sunday, we thank God for the gift of life. Welcome to the social justice table. Let's talk about the presidential entry age. The constitution of Zimbabwe is discriminatory because it only says you should be 40 for you to contest as a president. It only gives the entry age, but it doesn't give the age limit. That means a 100-year-old citizen can actually contest to be your president, Zimbabwe. That's awkward, right? There is no scientific evidence that says above 40-year-olds make better leaders. The presidents of Austria, Chad, Mali are below 40, and they are very good, doing a very good job. Look at it. General Tongogara was 36 when he passed away. He could have been the president in 1980. And if you look at all the people who went to fight in the armed struggle, they were below 40. So are we saying being a president is harder than fighting in the armed struggle? 60% of our population is youth. Chamisa is also not youth. He is not youth because he doesn't fall in the 60% population of the country. Kabila was 29 when he became the president. Gaddafi was 27. King Mswati was 28. Macron was 38. Thomas Sankara was below 40. He is still our role model. I'm here by lobbying all the youths of Zimbabwe to join me and my team in filing a constitutional court case to declare that clause in the constitution unconstitutional. We cannot have the presidential age entry without the presidential age limit. And besides, our youth make 60% of our population. The constitution is discriminatory against the youth based on age, Zimbabwe. I'm lobbying the youth to come on board. Thank you, Zimbabwe. Have a blessed Sunday. It's your girl, Dr. Amai. I love you, Zimbabwe. All right.